pick which one of these teams gets to play in the Final Four and which team will pay to watch from the stands. It all comes down to this game between the North Carolina Tar Heels and the Auburn Tigers.
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Tigers should be looking at a tough fight tonight, Dick. What have they got to do to win this thing?
They've got to stick to their game plan and focus on these keys. First, get a hand up in the face of all the outside shooters. Secondly, get the ball inside for the high percentage shot. That'll open up the outside game as well. And finally, get out on those shooters. Challenge every shot.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. He makes the block.
Take a look right here. There it is. It says, get it out of here. Thou shalt not enter thy lane. Right on the defensive end.
The point guard with the ball. He pump fakes. Ball in the paint. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I'll tell you, great spin move to the basket.
They'll work it around the arc. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Looking for a good shot. On the inside. Trying to draw the foul.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Inside. The center gets the ball. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The power forward takes. Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Garrison is fired up right now emotionally.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
He does the sweet fake shot. He shoots from the elbow. It sticks. He went right through that double team.
Hey, let's see if they decide to double next time down.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Shows patience waiting for the reset. For the bucket. And he missed. Leans in. Inside.
Pressure that basketball. There he is. Strips the ball loose.
Fed the low block. The center gets the pass. And in and out. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. The center takes the feed. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. He'll regroup the offense. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession. It's no good. Trying to pack it inside.
Great anticipation defensively.
They work the perimeter. Got an open look if he wants it. Jumps in. They just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now.
Number 50 with the fake. And now they'll bring it up. For two. Perfectly executed. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Look at speed. I tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
That's 8 unanswered.
Look at that spacing.
He puts up the tray, way off target. Gave it up. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
They're off into transition. Goes up for two. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Rod.
Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court.
He's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
Nick, they're really going to have to monitor this because they've hit the bottom mentally. They're really going to be in some big, big trouble. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Turns it over. Fast break opportunity here. And the jam. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad, before the game, the coaches told us their only worry was their team getting down too early. Now that this team has, the players are trying very hard not to panic and put it all together.
Thanks, Aaron. On the dribble, gives it up, fakes the jumper. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
North Carolina are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He wants a three. Off the rim and no good. Stolen away. Now in transition, trying to score the other way. Jumps into the defender. Contact causes the shot to come off.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
He blocks the shot. And the ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
On the outside. Definitely a foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Oh, makes a great move to draw the foul. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
It's good. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. working it around the perimeter. Controlling the ball. Will take the shot. Way off target. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Looking for a good shot. The skip pass is picked off. Fakes the shot. Gave it up. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Entry pass in the paint. Here's a double team. He rejects it. Moving it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose.
That's a high post screen, close to the lane.
He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. And a momentary look from three-point land. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. He shoots from long range. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Up and inside.
Hard foul. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
Way off target. At halftime, the Tigers are trailing by 14. We've really been on a roller coaster here tonight, Dick. Any highlights of the half for our viewers?
There were some good highlights in that first half, but you got to look at this one. Watch how they got the ball inside for easy scores, which forced the defense to collapse, opening up the perimeter game.
All right, Dick, let's get back to the action as the two teams are just about ready to start the second half. Auburn is showing little promise from the field in the first half, and Dick, you got to wonder if more of that is coming up in the second half.
Hey, do you think the coach is screaming a little bit down here in that locker room about shot selection? Coaches don't tolerate bad shot selection. He'll make sure it doesn't happen two halves in a row.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Erin. For two, perfectly executed.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
For the deuce. Dick, are they being taken out of their game offensively?
Hey, they're taking themselves out of the game by rushing bad shots and not executing an offense.
Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
A very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Ball handler's in trouble. Back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Nice fake.
Tries for two.
I love the sky hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
There's the fake.
Double team now, bad angle.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do.
There's a steal. It was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man. Pushing that basketball, help one another, communicate.
He nails the shot. On the dribble, gives it up, steals the pass. And the ball goes out of play. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
And ejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Rims out. Gave it up. Picked off. Pushes it up. Tries for two. Goes in. The Tigers trail by 17.
The frustration right there.
Cross court.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with oppositions. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you have great post play, you got a chance really to win.
Gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
That's a good post play because the footwork is excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake and good footwork, keeping his pivot foot down.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball though?
He pump fakes. The Tar Heels aren't afraid to recruit some big-time athletes, especially if you look at their track record.
They like guys who can really get up and down the court. Their basketball philosophies require great athletes.
And he'll kick it back outside. Here's a flash from the post up high. The shooting guard gets the ball. Oh, clinical drop step.
I tell you, clinic 101 on how to utilize the drop step from the low post. Look at that spacing.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Pump fakes. Let's it fly. Goes up for two. The dribble, gives it up. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
From left of the circle.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, it's obvious their backs are against the wall. It's going to take a lot of fight and desire to get back into this one. Defensive stops are the words that come to mind, and without them, they just don't have a chance.
With a bucket, perfectly executed. It's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Here we go on the break. Trying to draw some contact, and in and out. Now they work it around the perimeter. Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. He's got a nice shot fake. The ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
For the deuce.
He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen.
Jumped in front to take it away. For two. Can't get the shot to go. Picks off the pass. Shoots from right of the circle. Misses the three-point ball. Well, Dick, this game is all but over.
Yeah, now it's about damage control. Good time to get some of the bench players into the game to avoid injury.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Gave it up. Looking for a good shot. With a deep shot from outside. Off the rim and no good. From the top of the circle. Comes up empty.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Nice shot. The shooting guard gets the pass. He dials long distance. He cleans the glass. Wow, the defender walks into a vicious screen. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
He's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Good fake. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
What's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, locking shots, altering shots are all very important skills which your big players should possess.
Nails the J. I think he's trying to upset him with the taunts, that's for sure.
That could be a poor move on his part. He's taunting the opponent.
Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you've got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
the Tar Heels, wins and reaches the end of the road. These are the last road games of the season.
Hey, two wins are all they need, Mr. Nestler, and it's all they're thinking about as this team advances to the magical Final Four.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler. Good night, everybody.